Homelessness and drug addiction are two interrelated social issues that continue to torment communities across the United States. While they are always viewed in isolation, a deeper examination reveals a lot of related causes. Understanding the root causes of homelessness and drug addiction is essential for developing solutions to address these challenges. In 2020, more than 500,000 people were experiencing homelessness across America. 72% were individual adults, while 28% were people living in families with children. 40% of people experiencing homelessness live unsheltered, which means their primary nighttime residence is a place not suitable for human habitation, like a city sidewalk, abandoned building, or a park. Living unsheltered can impact a person's health and safety. This is Kensington, Philadelphia. It is obvious to the naked eye that Kensington is in a bad condition, but how did it get in this hopeless state? Kensington was once the center of the textile industry with the Bay Factory, which employed over 100,000 people in 1915, but after World War I kicked off, and the Great Depression followed in 1928, Philadelphia experienced what is called deindustrialization, as factories shut down, and for whatever reason, the textile industry moved to the American South. By 1935, Philadelphia lost almost all manufacturing jobs, leading to mass unemployment, and many European immigrants who believed that America would be paradise found themselves jobless. At the same time, 6 million African Americans were leaving the South, heading north to cities like Philadelphia. This migration drastically changed the demographics of Philadelphia. However, when they arrived in Philadelphia, they were not in paradise. They found themselves in a very different but still hostile environment, which makes sense given the fact that they immigrated during an economic decline and were seen as a threat to job security. In 1939, World War II begins just as the black population in Philadelphia hits 11%. Millions of men, both black and white, go to war. Then in 1945, the war ends and all the troops come home. President Roosevelt signed something into law called the GI Bill, also known as the Servicemen's Readjustment Act, which provided a wide range of benefits for returning veterans. Most importantly, the GI Bill provided low-cost mortgages and generous financial aid that made it possible for almost every returning veteran to afford a nice new family home. Yet 99% of black applicants were denied. Black people were confined to the north, inner west, and southeast of the city, which were the most neglected parts of Philadelphia. Kensington was one of a few non-segregated neighborhoods in Philadelphia, and was considered a concentration of undesirables, including low-class whites and blacks. Throughout the 1970s and 1980s, Kensington was the center of the Irish-American criminal gang known as the K&A Gang. This gang was a group of Irish burglars who decided to set up shop on the corner of Kensington and Allegheny. Since then, Kensington has been plagued with crime, homelessness, and drug addiction. Back to the current time, what are the current causes of homelessness witnessed in Kensington and in major cities across America? Mental illness and substance abuse play significant roles in contributing to homelessness. Many individuals experiencing homelessness struggle with untreated mental health conditions, such as depression and anxiety. The lack of access to mental health services and stigma surrounding mental illness prevent individuals from receiving timely treatment. Substance abuse is also a cause and consequence of homelessness. Inadequacy of social support systems also leads to homelessness due to no access to essential services, such as affordable housing, healthcare, and substance abuse treatment. limited availability of affordable housing options, and insufficient funding for mental health and addiction treatment services leave individuals experiencing homelessness and addiction. Also, serving jail time worsens the cycle of homelessness and drug addiction. Upon release from jail, individuals face significant barriers to settling back in society, including limited access to housing, employment, and social services. Without adequate support systems in place, many individuals struggle to reintegrate into society, increasing their risk of homelessness and relapse into substance abuse. In Kensington, many homeless people also struggle with fentanyl addiction. Fentanyl crisis in the United States has been fueled by various factors. One primary cause is the overprescription and misuse of prescription opioids. The impact of the fentanyl crisis in the United States has been devastating. The Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, or CDC, reports that fentanyl was involved in over 70% of all opioid-related overdose deaths in 2020. Families and communities are left struggling with the loss of loved ones, while individuals struggling with addiction face barriers to accessing treatment and support services. Education and awareness initiatives aimed at informing the public about the dangers of fentanyl and reducing stigma surrounding addiction are also essential components of a comprehensive response to the crisis. Another major crisis is the use of xylazine. Xylazine was approved for sedating horses, and its use in humans has devastating effects. Xylazine is a potent sedative and depressant, often leading to respiratory depression, overdose, and death when used in high doses or in combination with other substances. Addressing the underlying social determinants of drug abuse, such as poverty, unemployment, and lack of access to health care, is essential to preventing and mitigating the xylazine crisis in the long term. This includes investing in community development initiatives, affordable housing programs, and economic opportunities for marginalized communities. Homelessness and drug addiction in the United States are complex social issues with interconnected causes. Economic inequality, mental illness, substance abuse, inadequate social support systems, and punitive incarceration policies all contribute to the prevalence of homelessness and addiction in communities across the country. Addressing these root causes requires a multifaceted approach that prioritizes affordable housing, accessible health care and mental health services, comprehensive substance abuse treatment, and supportive reentry programs. By understanding and addressing the underlying factors driving homelessness and drug addiction, we can work towards creating a more equitable and compassionate society where every individual has the opportunity to thrive.